Hello everyone, this is Kelly Beard of KarmicTools.com and this is your weekly forecast for September 19th through the 25th of 2021. So this week's forecast is probably going to go up on Saturday afternoon, evening, because I need some new sunset videos. We've run through all the ones I've done already. So I'm hoping that you're watching something beautiful that I just filmed today. Meantime, it's a pretty packed week with fall equinox smack in the middle on Wednesday. We got a full moon on Monday and Mercury warming up for its retrograde activations. So our week kicks off on Monday the 20th with Mercury trining Jupiter for the first of three times. It's going to hit on September 20th, October 3rd, and October 31st, which is a magical zone of time, I got to tell you. For our consciousness to be expanded, for us to have this ease and grace with learning something new or learning to express in new ways. Tremendous support if we can rework it a little bit with this retrograde in Libra. So this energy is great for expanding your mind, learning something new, or taking a class. It's time to plan for the future and start getting organized. However, you may feel less disciplined and more creative, which is fine in the beginning. But eventually, focus and discipline will have to be engaged to ground your new ideas, thoughts, or concepts. You have to ask yourself, how bad do you want it? If you are self-aware, awake, and alert, you will be able to see and seize the opportunities as they present themselves. It may appear to be luck, but it's really more that you were in alignment with the cosmos, present and positive, and ultimately able to trust and follow your own instincts. Practice, there is no perfection. Being optimistic and looking for opportunity in every experience will magnetize the positive and naturally repel the negative, leading right where you want to be. Take advantage of this good energy to connect to whatever it is you are trying to create in your life at this time. Okay? So like I said, anything that you're trying to learn, something new, I'm trying to get a new routine to take root here. I'm learning all about mountain living and the mountain creatures, big and small. And so just where are you being expanded right now in your own consciousness? You might want to look to your Libra and Aquarius departments because that's where it's happening three times over. Jupiter's expanding your Aquarius department for the only time in 12 years, while Mercury's retrograding in Libra, which it only does every couple years too. So it's lingering though to rewire something and how we communicate with others and express ourselves along the way. So know that because this is three times over, that you can consciously co-create and really use this time to reorganize in your Libra department so that you can express something greater in your Aquarius department. So I'm going to leave the Mercury class registration links in here because this is going to be relevant all the way through the Mercury retrograde. So I'm going to say through the end of October, you do get your custom goodies. We did break it up into three parts. So we have some pre-shadow goodies, which is right now, what we want to look at right now. And then we have the during the retrograde goodies and then the post-shadow goodies. So anytime we're working with Mercury, it's usually kind of a three times over way. It's 3 weeks before, 3 weeks during, and 3 weeks after. And that's our zone of 9 weeks where we reset things quarterly. Plus, you'll get your personal activations, what Mercury is doing to you, and all of the up-in-the-sky ones, since we're having two of the three this week. So this is the kickoff. This is the pre-shadow period, where we're warming up for the retrograde that's going to happen at the end of the month. Also, on our Mercury-Jupiter day, we have the Pisces full moon, which can actually probably help that other activation clarify a few things, too. So before I dive into the Pisces full moon, I want to remind you about the rhythm. Our annual rhythm is such that we have winter, spring, summer, fall, which is always at Cancer, Capricorn, and Aries, Libra times. And during the winter, spring, summer, fall, which we're approaching our fall equinox moment this week, there's always movement and change and decisions and choices that we have to make during that new season, the new season of fall that's coming up for the fall harvest. This is when we start to organize everything that did work for the year and everything that did not work, we let go of so that we're not pouring resources out the window. The rhythm I would like to alert you to is that the month before those decisions and choices are made at winter, spring, summer, fall, the month before is when we process everything and try to examine all the information and gather everything that we need to make good decisions, right? After we make them, the month after winter, spring, summer, fall is associated with the Leo, Aquarius, and Taurus, Scorpio gates of power when we anchor things. So the rhythm is we process, choose, anchor. Process, choose, anchor. Now, the anchor part that is permanent can also be the permanently released, because after we've made choices and decisions, a lot of times things need to be cleared out because we're past it. We're making new decisions. So just know that that's the rhythm. And so with the Virgo Pisces lunation, I want you to think back to the month before spring equinox, which would have been the end of February, beginning of March, when we had the Pisces new moon. That has run its course 6 months. Essentially, when we seed the Pisces new moon, we're seeding the new vision for the year. How's it going? When we launch the new vision at spring equinox, we check in at fall equinox. How's it going? Also, where we are this month with this Pisces full moon, it is 2 weeks after the Virgo new moon. So essentially, what we want to clear this month is anything blocking that new routine from taking root, you know, exactly what we're talking about earlier. So let's use this full moon to illuminate our big dreams and visions and where we might need to tweak a little bit or release a little bit or change a little something, something, so that the vision can unfold by next spring in a beautiful, organic way. So Pisces full moon, we are out of the fixed energy of Leo. We are immersed in Virgo energy now, which has activated both the need to stabilize certain things as well as release permanently some aspect of self so that your life can actually work in the physical reality that you are currently living. That said, no matter how bad it is, change really is only one decision and a renewed commitment away. We are now moving through the mutable energy of Virgo, which can help us process and assimilate all that has lived and died thus far this year. Now is the time to make the necessary arrangements for new life to come in and thrive. Think nesting in the sense that you are preparing space for something new in your life. But because it is Virgo, it is more about how this new life or energy or direction is going to actually work into your natural rhythm and routine. Okay, deep breath. We want to have a natural rhythm and routine that's our own, and then we want to have the seasonal rhythm and routine that we kind of tap into periodically. If you made a ton of new connections and friends recently, and all your creativity was activated and your heart engaged with all that good Leo energy, then Virgo energy comes in and helps you create a new system and helps you get used to your new rhythm. It's time to create a whole new daily routine that better supports who you are and who you are becoming. We're all finding various systems and routines that have historically worked are now obsolete and no longer work for whatever reason. Doesn't even matter. That is always a clear indication that it's time for a new one. And if you are able to create one, tweaking as you go and leaving it open to further revisions, then when Libra comes next month, you'll be able to really make those connections with others, personally or professionally, which can create space for some powerful new relationships, partnerships, and collaborations. Deep breath. However, if you have spent the last month of Leo examining your own self-worth, wondering why you magnetize certain things in people and repel others, and generally feeling like the life you're living does not reflect who you are in your heart of hearts, then this month of Virgo will help you heal aspects of self that will enable you to be more congruent so that you can take advantage of the coming opportunities in Libra. Pisces full moon is the best for releasing illusions and delusions, any ways we've been unrealistic lately. It's the best full moon to release self-sabotage, compulsiveness, addiction, martyrdom, and victim consciousness, to name a few. We set some Virgo new moon intentions around the 6th of September, and now, 2 weeks later, the light is illuminating where we may have to be more practical and present. This is a purification time of year, so healthy boundaries are vital as you integrate the year and assimilate your personal harvest for 2021. Allow your imagination some space to connect to those creative solutions that are customized for you, and renew your connection to both a spiritual and physical daily practice. This is not news or news to you, I'm sure, but even if you have been the most dedicated and consistent ever, every year is an opportunity to freshen up the practice so that you are more inspired and uplifted. And if you need or want some help freshening up your practice, reach out to your mystic mentor. That would be me. I am happy to help with those things anytime. The energy this month supports you assessing your strengths and weaknesses and recommitting to balancing your soul work with your daily work, allowing the fragmented aspects of life to come together into a cohesive whole, and focusing on the little things that make the grand vision of your life work. The rapid pace with which this world is shifting, your time is much better spent on that which you deeply and truly value. Not narcotized or distracted by nonsense and propaganda, nor giving in to emotional overwhelm. Instead of deluding yourself, delaying your decisions, or taking timeouts with TV and the like, try to take some time to sit with your higher self in silent communion. Allow a conversation to evolve between yourself and Great Spirit. Intuition is like a muscle. You have to work it to gain strength. Trusting the guidance received during those quiet moments strengthens the connection to your own intuition. Keeping foremost in your mind that while the chaos and illusion swirls around you, you have the internal compass of the heart and your own intuition to rely on, and this is the month to fortify those connections. Deep breath. Pisces full moon is the best time of year, August, September, to release shame, blame, and guilt, and embrace the value of the lesson in every experience. Release criticism, judgment, and fear, and embrace compassion for others and patience with your own process. Deep breath. Release the addiction to unobtainable perfection and embrace trusting your creative spark and inherent beauty. Release petty distractions and victim consciousness and embrace your inner authority to direct your own life. Deep breath. So this Pisces full moon is going to be so juicy. That's on the 20th, and then on the 22nd, we have equinox itself, but we have another Mercury activation. So this is very powerful. Mercury square Pluto is going to happen three times over on September 22nd, October 1st, and November 2nd. So again, with the access the ancestors, the Scorpio gate of power is that entire first week of November, which is going to be when Mercury is finally going forward and moving out of Libra into Scorpio. And we're going to have a whole bunch of good juju for rebirthing a completely new concept of how we think and how we express ourselves. It's going to be so great. Meantime, this is some of the work we have to do. That's a little bit of assimilation and review and revise and go back over, right? So paying attention to this one, especially because it is Pluto. So anything you want to change about your ideas, thoughts, or concepts, or about your own way of thinking and expressing, this is the time to do it, especially because it's happening Libra to Capricorn. So it's in the zone that's going to make you better so that you magnetize better relationships. So we want to do this work with Pluto, even though sometimes it is very hard. This energy is a tough yet powerful one. Its highest expression would be to focus on your inner deep dig, discovery, and development. It enables you to look beneath the surface to some core drives and gain some valuable insights, and thus choose a plan of action based on your findings. You will want to know all the hidden meanings behind decisions you've made or want to make soon. Dig. You may find more than you think you're ready for, but apparently the universe thinks differently. Pay attention and try not to worry about what anyone else thinks or believes. This energy's flip side is to make you obsess over one particular idea and try to force others to your way of thinking. That is a bottomless pit. You cannot truly change the way other people think. You can only change the way you think and hope it enlightens others along the way. And it will, for those who are tuned into your frequency or level of consciousness. Try to only focus on you and your own direction. Deep breath. This is huge and absolutely with a Mercury retrograde. This would be important if it was only hitting it once, but it's going to do this three times over. And again, check in with your Libra and Capricorn departments now. How's that going? So like I said, same day, Wednesday the 22nd, is equinox. So Shanta and I are having a Zoom at 3 o'clock East Coast time. That's 12 noon Pacific. And then a little bit later after that, Cinnamon and I are going to get together and do an Instagram Live. So these are two completely different circles of my people. And I look forward to connecting with all of you for this season of balance. And I hope that you will consider joining us in one or both places. You can link in here to register for the Zoom with me and Shanta. And of course, with IG Live, you don't have to do anything. You just show up. So we'll see you there. And if you want to make a love offering, you can use that same donation button for $22 and support the community, support the cause here. We love sharing the energies and meditations. Shanta and Cinnamon are very different. Shanta channels the archangels and has an incredible ability to synthesize what I present, while Cinnamon has her own way of synthesizing what I present. And I love it because it helps integrate it into our body and our physicality in a certain way that is her specialty. And where Shanta's kind of like a meditation, Cinnamon's more like a shamanic journey. It's a visualization that we walk through and it's embodied. Both of them are spontaneous. I mean, both of them just sort of wing it when we're there, but I just love it. It's so diverse. We're going to cover all our bases for equinox and have a great time together. And hopefully you're available since it is a Wednesday. I know that's kind of funky, but we're going to get together and it all will be recorded and posted where we can. Then the next day, Thursday, September 23rd, we have Venus oppose Uranus. This is a pretty big deal too. Anytime Uranus is involved, it becomes the wild card and hard to predict how things will unfold. But right now, there is a push-pull between your apparent values and your unique individual self. Venus also represents relationships, so you may begin an unusual relationship or you may have something unusual happen in an established relationship. It is not necessarily a quote-unquote good or bad thing, as much as it is an unpredictable shift or sudden awareness, which requires some compromise and integration. This energy works beautifully if your personal truth and values are in alignment. It will be very disruptive if they are not. Be open and flexible while looking for the win-win situation for all involved. Okay, deep breath, y'all. This is where we have to pay attention to the fact that we're shifting into Libra, which is Venus's domain. Uranus is living in Taurus, which is ruled by Venus. There's a lot of feminine energy here to soften the edges of what might feel radical and unexpected, that Uranus can shake things up in our relationships or finances when Venus is involved. But again, this is a personal planet to a collective planet. So it's more important that you just sort of pay attention to the awakening that's happening within you, or the prompts, or the, you know, the ways you're being pushed to grow, and make sure that you stay tuned in to your own values and priorities, right? And Venus in Scorpio is soul level. This is when we tune into our soul and its values, its priorities. And we get this about once a year and across from Uranus, again, with an awakening. Something is being liberated within you, the individual, so that you can no longer relate in the old ways, which is totally in alignment with all the other activations and things coming up that are telling us we have to discover and we have to develop new ways of being in social situations. And that goes for dating too, you know, beyond just social, you know, intimate situations are changing too. How do we do that going forward? Then our last activation is Saturday, September 25th, and it's Mars trine Saturn. So I like this. Venus and Uranus are liberating and awakening and working something out to change something, while Mars is having ease and grace with Saturn where we can ground something. Okay, so I like this. This is a delicious and potent combo. This is like a great father-son working on a project type of energy. The son has all the muscle, energy, and enthusiasm, and the father is the brilliant, steady man who directs that energy and teaches in every moment. Internally, this is your inner authority guiding your innate desire nature to the tangible results it so craves. Saturn brings the long-term goals to the table, and Mars's energy can fuel your efforts, creating amazing results. This energy enables you to focus longer, attend to the details, overcome obstacles, and get more tangible results of your actions. Normally, these two getting together is more of the tortoise and the hare energy, which can be frustrating for some folks. However, they are in an easy angle, and if there is any major project which needs your attention, now is the time you will likely be in the mood to tackle it, and you will be completely supported by these energies. So I like it. The full moon's going to illuminate some things. Mercury going backwards is going to help change our thinking on some things. Our masculine feminine is working it out with Uranus and Saturn, who are also working it out up in the sky. This is a really good week with Equinox to restore balance, to check in with balance. Where have you gotten off track? Where have things gotten a little extreme? What needs your attention? What's been neglected the most? We say the same thing about the Mercury retrograde coming down the pike. It's going to be a time to review, revise, go back over the last 3 months. How's it been going? What's up with your choices and decisions? Are you feeling good about them? Are they effective and serving you? So remember, Virgo Pisces time is always time to check in with your spirit in a human form. It's time to reset your systems so that they work better. Again, sometimes we get into rhythms and routines that have us go, 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 and we need to pause and restore balance. We're going to have access to that for the next 6 weeks at a minimum. And even if you're in the other hemisphere approaching spring equinox, it's still our once in two times of the year that we have access to physical, literal balance. So I always encourage you to drink it in. All right, everyone. That is our forecast. We've got the equinox events. We've got the Mercury retrograde that's still got a great class with three recordings and a whole bundle of tools for general Mercury retrograde, for it going through Libra, rituals and meditations and divinations that we did for each portion of the pre-shadow, post-shadow, and the actual retrograde. Really good supportive juju for anyone looking to navigate this Mercury retrograde a little more consciously. Definitely reach out. And thank you so much for being part of my community. Thanks for listening. This is Kelly Beard of Karmic Tools signing off. Have a fantastic week.